I started shooting small things with DV for my website with the Sony PD150, low res DV. And I start kind of falling in love with this camera. And when I first started what later became Inland Empire, I would get ideas for say just one scene. And not knowing if it was going to go any further, I started shooting with this camera. And so when more and more came, I stuck with that camera. However, I fell in love with shooting with this small camera with automatic focus, with 40-minute takes, lightweight, seeing exactly what you get, smaller crew. It was so fantastic for me and for the scenes that I could never go back to film. I love Hollywood, and I think I'm not alone. I love the dream of it. I love the light there. I live there. And I love the feel of it. And I always say, when you're there in LA, on some nights in the summer, maybe the spring, this night jasmine smell comes. And sometimes there's a wind. And you can feel the golden age of Hollywood in the air. And it's pretty magical. And there's big studios, big sound stages. And I love these big sound stages, factories for making cinema. So there's, and then there's the star system and all this, going on. It's all kind of part of this dream. There's a lot wrong with it, but that part is a big lure to people. Laura Dern is one of the all-time great actresses. She could play anything, and she's just so, like I say, a great actress makes it real from a deep place, and Laura can do that. And she's like family to me. I've known her since Blue Velvet. And I mean, I've known a lot of people longer, but they're not like so much family. I don't know what it is. We've got a connection. But I hadn't seen her for a long time. But she came, walking down my street one day announcing that she was my new neighbor. And this meeting started Inland Empire. I get an idea. Now, you get a lot of ideas. In a day, you can get a lot of ideas, but you don't get an idea, but rarely, that you fall in love with, deeply in love with. And when that day comes, it's a beautiful day. And so you fall in love with this idea, and you fall in love with it also for what you see cinema could do to it. And so then you translate that idea to cinema. And so there's so much that can go wrong, and it's not quite right. You're checking the idea, and you're going like that. And you're trying to get all these elements to feel correct based on the idea. So when it finally feels correct to you, then you hope it feels correct to others. I always say the same thing, but when it gets abstract, stories can hold abstractions. Cinema can say abstractions. When it gets abstract, there's many, many interpretations. But you can never, I don't think, make a film for some, abstract audience. The world's changing all the time. You'd go nuts. People for sure try, but it's there's it's filled with surprises. Well, I only did, I went out with a cow and a placard for Laura Dern. And it was, a necessity because I didn't have the money to buy ads in the trades, which are super expensive. The trades are filled with these ads, and you begin to wonder, is that money really, if someone is someone going to see a picture and change their vote? And I don't think so. But they're not necessarily going to change their vote if they see me with a cow either. But it brings awareness, and it brought awareness. But still, Laura didn't get a nomination. Very rarely, but I always say, I love the dream logic. Cinema can say a dream logic, which is an abstraction. It can say things that are difficult to say in words. Just like when you have a dream, so much understanding for you, but when you try to tell your friend, it's very difficult to say in words something that will give your friend the same experience you had. So, but cinema can be the dream, can give that thing. Still, there's different interpretations.